The 2023 NFL season starts this Thursday. So today in Madden 24, I'm going to be simulating the entirety of the NFL season to see who wins the Super Bowl. And what better way to start out this video than checking out Aaron Rodgers with his New York Jets team taking on the Buffalo Bills Monday night primetime, and it's Rodgers to Wilson for 9. And I want to know in the comments down below, who do you have winning the Super Bowl this year as Rodgers is dropping back to pass and again has Garrett Wilson. I got Garrett Wilson on my fantasy team this year, so I'm looking for a big year out of him. My Super Bowl pick, I'm going Chiefs. And in the NFC, let's go with the 49ers, a Chiefs 49ers Super Bowl. But in Madden, anything could happen, so I'm very curious to see who is going to come out through all these divisions, through each conference, make it to the Super Bowl, and win the Super Bowl, and down goes Rodgers. I am excited for NFL football to be back. Summer takes too long when football is on the other side of it. And Rodgers, 3rd and 15, is picked. Aaron Rodgers has thrown his first interception on his first drive with his new team. And let's see who comes away with the win. Halfway through this game, Bills lead by 2 touchdowns. End of the third quarter. It is 28-17 Buffalo. But here come the Jets. Down 8 points. Aaron Rodgers, it's 3rd and 11. From the Bills' 16-yard line, a touchdown here with 14 seconds to go is what he needs. And a 2-point conversion. Rodgers fires and misses its 4th down. Rodgers with the football in his hands to extend the game, send it to overtime. It's dropped! Aaron Rodgers and the Jets lose their first game of the season. And we are going to take a look at one more game before we simulate all the way to the playoffs and jump into playoff football. And that is with the number one overall pick of the draft, Bryce Young, getting the ball to his new receiver, Adam Thielen, for 17. Will Bryce Young be the offensive player of the year? Will it be CJ Stroud, Bijan Robinson, Anthony Richardson, just to name a few of the elite rookies in the league this year? It's a good year for rookie players, especially on the offensive side of the ball. And there's Miles Sanders for 5. Bryce Young got to pick up this first down right here, though. Miles Sanders is going to have a great year, in my opinion, under Frank Reich's coaching in Carolina. Picks up the first. Now we got our first red zone chance for Bryce Young. 3rd and inches from the 17. They're going empty. Don't take a sack, Bryce. Go to the sideline. And Miles Sanders drops it. Will they go for it? And they will go for it. 4th and inches. Frank Reich, Bryce Young. They're getting aggressive here. First drive of the year. And already going for it on 4th. Bryce is going to throw. He's got Hayden Hurst, and he's got a first. Now Bryce on 1st down again. He's going sideline. He's got Thielen, and Thielen going to get to the 4. Let's see. Bryce Young. Now Miles Sanders has it. Miles Sanders dives into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. We got a defensive game, but Carolina's up 14-0. Make it 17-0. This will be a big win when you get later on in the year. And the division's on the line. You have the tiebreaker over the Saints. Panthers could go to the playoffs. It's 31-10. Bryce Young destroys his division rival in just his 2nd game of the year. And your playoff standings in the AFC at the end of the year. Chargers, 1st in the AFC, 14-3. Broncos also go 14-3. Bengals, 13-4. Bills, 12-5. Titans, 11-6. Chiefs go 10-7. And the Jets get the last spot, tying at 9-8 with 4 other teams. And in the NFC, it's the Cowboys at 14-3, the 1 seed. Saints go 12-5. 49ers 12-5. Falcons 11-6. That's a little bit of a shocker. Eagles 10-7. Giants get in again. And the Chicago Bears win the NFC North at 7-10. The NFL's passing leader goes to Dak Prescott with 4,650 yards. Joe Burrow threw 44 touchdowns, though, and 5 picks. The NFL's rushing leader is Saquon Barkley of my New York Giants, almost 1,900 rushing yards, 13 touchdowns, but Eckler with about 1,800 yards of his own and 22 touchdowns. The NFL receiving leader is CeeDee Lamb with almost 1,600 yards, 14 touchdowns, Debo, 1,458 yards, 22 touchdowns, and Cooper Kupp above 1,400 with Jefferson with 13 touchdowns and 4 respectively. And Aaron Donald did Aaron Donald things, leading the league in sacks with 24, Micah Parsons with 18.5, and Max Crosby with 16. And we're going to be jumping into one playoff game per round, and we'll start it off with the 7-10 Bears against the 11-6 Falcons. How did the Bears win their division and get to host a playoff game at 7-10? The NFC North was that bad. I guess Jordan Love wasn't that good. DJ Moore just out of bounds on that one. I guess the Lions didn't live up to the hype that they had this year, and the Vikings completely fell apart from last year. The Bears, 7-10. I can't believe that. The Bears are projected to finish last, but I think they can win the division. I actually picked them to win the division with my predictions for every single division, but at 7-10, I didn't expect that. 3rd-3 for Fields. What's he going to do here? Over the middle, it's dropped. That's that 7-10 team right there. Oh, instead, we're checking out Desmond Ridder, Bijan Robinson, and Bijan Robinson must have had an awesome rookie year because he's already got a superstar ability. And the Falcons went 11-5 or 11-6? 11-6. So what did the Falcons do right this year? Was it the run game? Was it all Bijan Robinson? Or did Desmond Ridder take a step up? But there goes Bijan to the outside for 7. I'm surprised at this rate that Bijan didn't lead the NFL in rushing. He's getting the ball every play. But there's the play action, action. Desmond Ridder over the middle. Drake London, touchdown Atlanta. And let's see who moves on. The Falcons at 11-6. Or the 7-10 Bears. I think the Bears' Cinderella run is going to end, but at 35-3, are the Falcons a team to be reckoned with in the NFL this year, winning it 45-10. In the divisional round, we're going to check out the Cowboys and the Eagles go at it. Cowboys had a bye. They were the number one seed. Can they finally make it to a conference championship game? But they got to make it through the NFC winners from last year, the Philadelphia Eagles. And Pollard starts it off at 13 yards. And we'll see right now if Dak can convert this third down. Here comes the pressure. The dump off to Pollard. The blocking. And Pollard fights for the first. But the Cowboys go right back to third down. But Dak, the NFL's leading passing leader, delivers to Michael Gallup. They will go for it. Mike McCarthy getting aggressive. Gallup's wide open over the middle. Dak sees him. And Michael Gallup to the 8. Dak, play action. First and goal. You got plenty of time, Dak. Take your time. Don't get set. What is that? Dak, that is a terrible sack to take. But if you could live up here on 3rd-19, that'd be crazy. CeeDee Lamb, touchdown. Dak delivers a strike and CeeDee makes a great catch. And Dallas, don't worry. You get a touchdown. Now, Jalen Hurts, it's your turn to answer. All the abilities on that Eagles offensive line. And Jalen gonna run with it. He had the edge. He went back up the middle, but still gets the first. Eagles at midfield. Can they keep the drive going or will Dallas take over? Up 7-0. The Dallas defense, Micah Parsons. Can he get loose? He can't. Great protection. And Jalen Hurts delivers an absolute strike. That's the drive, Jalen. From the 7-yard line, you got 3 chances. It's a touchdown, Olamide Zaccheaus. I believe I said his name right. If I didn't, feel free to correct me in the comments down below. It's not Brown. It's not Devontae Smith. It's not Goddard. It's Zaccheaus. Tie game. What a game this might be. Dallas answers with a touchdown. Eagles come right back with a touchdown. Eagles take the lead. Cowboys take the lead. What a game. Can Dallas make it to the conference championship? They take an 11-point lead. They're up 18. Goodbye, Philadelphia. Hello, NFC Championship. The Cowboys move on. And in a very surprising AFC Championship matchup, we're jumping in with the Chargers versus Titans. The Titans beat the Chiefs. The Chargers beat Aaron Rodgers. So, Jets fans, you made it to the divisional round. And for the first time, I just realized in Mahomes' career, he isn't in the AFC Championship game. The Chargers now have a clear path to the Super Bowl. All they have to do is go through King Henry, D-Hop, and the Tennessee Titans. The Chargers. Tannehill. He's got a wide open receiver with a ton of room to go, I believe. Is that Austin Hooper? Is he still on this team? That was actually Josh Wile. Maybe a rookie. I've never heard of him before, I'll be completely honest. Tannehill again going to throw. Ton of protection for Ryan Tannehill. And he's going to take his receiver for about 11 yards. We haven't seen a team hold the other team to 3. It's either 0 points or 7 points. And will it start now? It might, but it's 4th-and-inches. I would imagine the Titans are going to go for it. Yes, they will. When you have King Henry, you're going to go for it on 4th-and-inches. We've seen so many 4th-and-inches, 4th-and-1s. And King Henry says, get off me, first down. You got D-Hop singled out, bottom of your screen right here. Is D-Hop going to get the ball? Play action, action. Tannehill, ton of time. Is he going to run? No, he'll walk into a sack. It'd be a huge hold for this Chargers defense. Hold the Titans to 3. Give Herbert a chance to answer here. And that's exactly what will happen. It looks like Justin Herbert has delivered after getting paid this offseason. Austin Eckler, what a cut. Austin Eckler looking to spin. He picks up 16. Chargers have had the talent the last few years. Two elite receivers in Mike Williams and Keenan Allen. An elite running back in Austin Eckler. Elite defensive players. A top 5, 6, 7 quarterback in the league. And Eckler could be off to the races. No, Byard's back there for the tackle. 2nd and 7 from the 8. Herbert to Eckler. Eckler up the middle, and that's what he does, and score touchdowns. Titans answered back in a flash. They'll make it 17-7. The Chargers don't know what just hit them. It's the third quarter, and the Titans are up 16. Chargers haven't scored since the opening drive. They finally get one and the two-point conversion, but the Titans get a 15-point lead, and the Tennessee Titans are headed to Super Bowl 58. The Cowboys lost to the Falcons, so the Super Bowl is the Titans versus the Falcons. My first time seeing the Super Bowl 58 intro, Allegiant Stadium. Vegas were here, the Falcons, a rookie Bijan Robinson, second year Drake London, Desmond Ridder is here against a veteran, Derrick Henry, Ryan Tannehill, there's D-Hop, the Lombardi Trophy is on the line. Neither of these teams have ever won a Super Bowl, so the Falcons or the Titans will claim their first Lombardi Trophy. At the end of this game, the question is, who's it going to be? Make your predictions. 3rd and 5 for Desmond Ridder, are they going to go 3 and out to start the game? Ridder over the middle, strong catch, that's Mac Hollins. Right back to 3rd down though, we see Kyle Pitts make a play. Drake London make a play. What happens here on 3rd? It's a screen to Cordell. It's a screen to Corbett. I can't speak, but Cordarrelle Patterson. I don't know why, I just couldn't speak for a second. It was a screen to Cordarrelle Patterson, and he picked up 27. I thought this drive was done. The Titans allowed a huge first down from Cordarrelle Patterson, and now the Falcons inside the 20. Ridder over the middle, it's Pitts, and Kyle Pitts to the 4. 2nd and goal. Ridder, we got Bijan the backfield. They're going to pitch it to him. Bijan Robinson to the corner. Touchdown, Atlanta. Tannehill and the Titans. Can you answer? Derrick Henry. He's running to the left. Henry, one man to beat, and he can't beat Jesse Bates. But here come the Titans anyway. 1st and 10 from the 27-yard line. Tannehill. Almost picked again. You gotta pick him off there in the Super Bowl. Falcons had 2 chances to pick off Tannehill and end this drive. Now it's 3rd and 6. Guaranteed 3 for the Titans if Tannehill doesn't throw another pick. Or get sacked and out of field goal range. He gets sacked for 8, but they should be able to hit this kick. Super Bowl 58. Who takes home the Lombardi? Titans take the lead. Falcons answer. Falcons make it 21-10, 24-10. Atlanta's not playing around. Will they choke another Super Bowl lead? They're up 17. They're up 24. It will not be a 28-3 repeat. The Atlanta Falcons have finally claimed their first Lombardi Trophy. The Falcons are Super Bowl champions with Desmond Ridder, Bijan Robinson, Kyle Pitts, Jesse Bates, AJ Terrell. What a season for these guys. I believe they won 11-6 in the regular season and now champion. Bring on the Lombardi Trophy. The Super Bowl animation is the same as Madden 23, but that's fine. Maybe even Madden 22. I don't know how long this has been the animation. But the Falcons have never hoisted the Lombardi Trophy in this animation. So Desmond Ridder, you get to hoist this thing. The Atlanta Falcons are your 2023 NFL season Super Bowl champs. Desmond Ridder wins Super Bowl MVP. NFL MVP goes to Joe Burrow. Sean Payton back with the Broncos wins Coach of the Year. Debo, Offensive Player of the Year. Aaron Donald, Defensive Player of the Year. Bijan Robinson, Offensive Rookie of the Year. And Jack Campbell of the Lions, Defensive Rookie of the Year. That's going to do it for the video, everyone. If you enjoyed it, do me a favor, hit the like button, hit that subscribe button if you're new, and make sure to go check out my other channels, which are in the description down below. And I'll talk to you all in the next one. Peace.